Hey, it's me, Kaylee. Are you ready to learn how to speak in algebra? This lesson will give us a lot of new words to describe what's going on in math and the world around us. Let's go. Have you ever written an essay or a book report? You might not remember it, but at some point you had to learn how to write a paragraph, and before that, you had to learn how to write a sentence. You learned that saying the dog is not a complete sentence, because a complete sentence needs a subject and a verb. The dog is just a subject. We need a verb too, like barked or ran. The dog barked and the dog ran are both complete sentences. Now don't worry, this isn't English class, but this is true in math too. Just like it's important to know what someone means when they say, "I don't like this verb, can we change it to something more action-packed?" You know they're referring to barked and not the subject, the dog. Mathematicians often work in groups or teams, and as they solve big, complex math problems, it's important for one mathematician to understand the other when she says, "I don't agree with the fourth term," or "I think the coefficient on the first term is wrong." Math has a common language to help us solve problems faster and easier. Let's take a look at this long expression here. When we come across an expression like this, the first things we want to look for are the terms, or how many terms are in our expression. Terms are simply the things being added or subtracted, or the things that are separated by addition and subtraction signs. So how many terms do you think are in this expression? Yeah, that's right, we have three terms, right? We have this one here, and this one here, because these are all separated by addition or subtraction signs. So we could write out our terms are 4x, 10y, and 14 times 9. These three things are what we call terms. So this expression has three terms. Simple enough, right? Now let's talk about factors. The factors are the things being multiplied together in each term. So let's look at our first term. What is our first term? Yeah, our first term is right here, 4x. So what is being multiplied together in the first term? 4 and x. So if we write our factors here, we're going to go through each of our terms. So how many factors are in our second term? Our second term is 10y. What's being multiplied together? Yeah, 10 and y. So how many factors are in our second term? Yeah, there's two, 10 and y. And how many factors are in our first term? Also two, 4 and x. Now in this last term, how many factors are there? Remember, what does this dot or this bullet, what does that mean? Yeah, that's right. This means multiplication, right? So that just means multiplication. So if there's two things being multiplied together in my third term, what are my factors? Yeah, 14 and 9. So there are two factors in my third term. Now let's take a closer look at our first term, 4x. We have two factors here, right? 4 and x. Now, what is the name for x? Why do we use a letter in algebra? That's right, x is our variable. And a variable is just a number that can have a different value. It's a number that is a varying value. Now, where else in our expression here do we have another variable, another varying value? So we have one here in x, and do we have another one? Yeah, this y is also a variable. Now in our third term, are either of these factors a varying value? No, we don't have any variables here, right? So there's none in our third term. Now, when we are multiplying a constant value like this 4 here by a variable, this constant value also has a special name. It's called a coefficient. A coefficient is the constant value that's being multiplied by a variable. So where are the coefficients in our expression here? Yeah, so we know that this 4 is a coefficient because it's a factor, it's being multiplied by a variable. Now, are there any coefficients or constant values being multiplied by a variable in our second term? Are either of our factors 10 or y a coefficient? Yeah, 10 is a coefficient. And how do we know? Because it's being multiplied by y, and we know that y is a variable. Now, what about 14 and 9? Are both of these numbers coefficients because they're constant values? Nope, actually there's no coefficients in our third term because neither of these are a variable. So even though they're constant values, since they're not being multiplied by a variable, we do not refer to them as coefficients. Nice work. Here's a simple table to help you keep track of all the new vocabulary words we've just learned. These words are super important in being able to communicate complicated formulas and equations. It might be a good idea to pause the video and copy this table down in your notebook to help you study. We'll do some more examples in the next video called Parts of Algebraic Expression Examples. I'll see you there. Hey, hey.